Hi there, it's me again. Last video we looked at the most basic skiing exercise, namely the snowplow. And as I said in this video, we're slowly going to go parallel. This is the exercise we frequently do after the snowplow, and it's very similar except for one key difference. As you probably noticed, we close the snowplow in the second half of the turn. In German this is called something like carving ground level. Why? I really don't know, but it is what it is. Let's have a look at the three steps of this exercise in detail. Step number one, initiate the turn by getting your new outside ski away from the inside ski to get into the snowplow. Step number two, proceed to press the outside ski to turn into the fall line as we do usually. And step number three, as soon as you are in the fall line, start closing the snowplow by slowly moving the inside ski back towards the outside ski. The key word here is slowly. And finally, we're back at step number one, opening the snowplow again. All right, cool, but why would we do that? Good question. I gave the reason for doing these exercises in the last video, but here is a quick recap. Do these exercises so you can fundamentally change your skiing. For example, getting your knees forward, changing the position of the hip, or other fun stuff that is really, really difficult to change. Damn, that was a quick video. Next time we'll talk about one of the most difficult slow skiing exercises. Yep, it's just parallel slow skiing. If you want to know why I think it's really difficult, then subscribe so you don't miss it, and maybe like the video for four paws. Thanks a lot for watching, and I'll see you next time.